3 Blue 1 Brown recently released a video entitled Why Probability of Zero Does Not Mean Impossible. It's a great introduction to the current thinking on continuous probability theory. Check it out. In this video, I'll very quickly go over the dartboard paradox and related ideas that Grant presents, and then I'll present a different perspective on the paradox in which it's not so paradoxical. Okay, so here's my 1-minute super condensed summary of Grant's video. Imagine a machine that randomly generates real numbers between 0 and 1 with a bias towards the larger numbers. There is some probability that the randomly generated number will fall within each of these ranges. The probability that any of these four outcomes will occur is the sum of the individual probabilities, and it adds up to 1. Refining the ranges, we get more ranges with lower probabilities. And if you go to the limit, you get infinite ranges, each with a probability of 0. Summing the probabilities of each outcome, you get 0, suggesting that no outcome is possible. It's the dartboard paradox. So what we do to sidestep this paradox is work with probability density. The probability density of a range is the probability of an occurrence in that range divided by the width of that range. And we do this because the probability density doesn't shrink to 0 as we refine the ranges. The area under the probability density function is always 1. In order to talk about probability, we must talk about areas under the probability density function. In other words, we must talk about the probability of an occurrence across a range of outcomes. Okay, that was a quick summary. Watch the 3 Blue 1 Brown video for a detailed and better paced explanation. But essentially, we introduce probability density to sidestep the paradox. Did we succeed? As a reminder, probability density was defined as the probability of an occurrence in a range divided by the width of that range. But for continuous variables, the width of each range is 0. Can we calculate probability densities across a 0-width range? Or is that akin to dividing by 0? Consider this. This plot can be constructed using two approaches. One approach is to construct the whole from the parts, assembling points to form a continuum. Now, if we interrupt the construction, we're left with a finite number of points and a trivial continuum. So, to produce the original plot, we must complete the construction and place infinite points. The other approach is to construct the parts from the whole, cutting up a continuum. What we get are more continua, separated by a void. I'm going to call parts of the void edges, and other parts vertices, but we'll need to remember that they correspond to the absence of continua. If we interrupt this construction, we're left with something non-trivial. If we complete the construction, cutting up this continuum in every possible way, there is a vertex at every location, and vertices correspond to the absence of continua, so we're left with a trivial continuum. So if you ask me, can we calculate probability density across a 0-width range with a point-based construction, I would say no, and yes. No, because we never want to divide by 0. So what we do is calculate probability densities for ranges approaching 0-width. Yes, because we end up with probability densities across 0-width ranges. We have a probability density for every real number between 0 and 1, and the relation between these two infinite sets is the probability density function. With the continuum-based construction, if you ask me the same question, I would say that the question makes no sense, because probability densities are not calculated across ranges. Okay, let me explain this claim by walking through the construction step by step. We start with a continuum, having four edges, each described by an equation, and four vertices, each described by coordinates. There's nothing more here. No points, no curves, just a continuum with four edges and four vertices. Every cut we make is described by an equation. And if we make this cut, we have the probability density function. What's the probability density corresponding to 0.5? Well, this system can't answer that question. But if we make the cut associated with x equals 0.5, then that vertex emerges. And then we can say that the probability density is 1. Vertices emerge as cuts are made. With this construction, we never produce infinite sets, and the probability density function is not a relation between those sets, or any pair of sets. The probability density function is a finite piece of information that we can use to determine how this cut would interact with any other cut made to the system. And with this approach, if we want to calculate the area under a curve, we would approximate it using the information at the vertices. And if that's not good enough, we can make more cuts, and more cuts, and keep on cutting it such that the distance between cuts approaches zero. With this construction, that's what an integral is. It's an endless, incomplete process. Let me conclude by returning to the dartboard paradox. Probability is calculated as the area under the probability density function within a specified range. As that range gets smaller, outcomes are removed. If we take this process to the limit, that range has zero width. So how many outcomes does a zero width range include? With the point-based view, we have to say one. A point exists within a zero width range, corresponding to a single outcome. So with the point-based view, it is meaningful to discuss the probability of a single outcome occurring. It has a probability of zero. In fact, the probability of any single outcome occurring is zero. But since single outcomes can have non-zero probability densities, they are possible. A probability of zero does not mean impossible. With the continuum-based view, we have to say zero. Only cuts can exist within zero width ranges, and they correspond to the absence of outcomes. So with the continuum-based view, it is meaningless to talk about single outcomes. Probability density can only ever describe a cut. Probability can only ever describe a continuum. A probability of zero means a collection of outcomes is impossible. With this view, there is no paradox. Now, I want to make it clear that the point-based construction is how we do math. The continuum-based construction simply offers a different perspective on the dartboard paradox. We should not discard established ideas just because a different view might offer a more appealing resolution to a single paradox. And to be frank, the continuum-based construction introduces more questions than answers. But that doesn't mean it's wrong or right. The way I see it is that it means it's worth talking about. So let's talk about it. Throw your thoughts in the comments, and thanks for watching.